forensic lectures. In this video lecture, we are going to see electrophoresis. So what we will cover today is what is electrophoresis, high and low voltage electrophoresis, and immunoelectrophoresis. So let us first see electrophoresis. So it is a process like it's a chromatographic technique by which a mixture of charged molecule is separated according to what they are sized, okay, when placed in what electric field. So that's why it's electrophoresis, because we are using here electric field. And it determines the accurate size, like if we take the example of RNA DNA, okay. So it is as important as reduction of molecular weight by any other molecules subjected to electrophoresis. So it can be anything, it will determine its accurate size, okay, this electrophoresis using what? Electric field. So there are this gel electrophoresis, which is there. In that, there are three types of varieties. That is the starch gel electrophoresis, polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, and agarose gel electrophoresis. So these are commonly used electrophoresis. We'll see them in the next video lecture. Okay. So the principle which is based on this electrophoresis is that the migration and separation of charged particle. What are the charged particles? They ions, okay, under the influence of what? Electrophoresis. So there are positively charged ions and the negatively charged ions, right? We have two types of ions, positively charged, that is cathode and anode, right? So it is only based on the separation and migration of these particles. So they are connected by a connectivity medium called as an electrolyte, okay. So also this gel electrophoresis, which is there, it is a separation between the surface particle, okay, mainly and the fluid immediately surrounding it. Means a setup will be like a beaker will be there, in that solution will be there. There will be a anode and a cathode node. Like we have done the experiment of NaCl, right? Intense standard or 12 standard. So separation using a battery, right? We have connected this using a battery. This is a common setup, right? So it is like that. So it is applied electric field act on then resulting the charge density, causing the particle to migrate and the fluid around the particle to flow. So the one type of charged particle will be accumulated over here, other type of like positive or negative, okay, according to anode and cathode. So next, the components that are there, like the wicks will be there. It will support the medium with the buffer to complete the circuit. Like it is like this type of setup, right? So here this will be anode, and if we take this at cathode, then this will be connected with the medium, and there will be a buffer solution which will be there. And supporting medium which provide a matrix where the separation takes place. Then cover will be there to reduce evaporation of buffer and prevent contamination during electrophoresis run. So here all this thing which will be there, it will be not in the open pump, it will have a cover. So the power supply will be there, which provides an electric field for the movement of charged particle. So here we can connect a battery or other type of electric charged a device which stores electricity, okay. Then the steps which needs to be followed is that first we need to prepare the sample for running. Then the agarose gel, TAE gel solution is prepared, okay. Then casting the gel is done. Then setting up the electrophoresis chamber is done. Then loading the gel, and then the process of electrophoresis is done. And once it is done, we have to stop it, okay, and visualize the DNA, RNA, or whatever the sample you have taken. So next is the application. Application is like they are used in DNA fragmentation, DNA analysis, protein detection, testing of antibodies. Also, it's a separation technique, right? So it is an essential technique for separation and analysis of nucleic acid. So here nucleic acid means all the other types of nucleic acid will be included. Then capillary electrophoresis, which is there, it is like a small tube, okay, tube structure. Like the electrophoresis technique used to separate molecule based on what charge and size, right? So this capillary electrophoresis, it's mostly dependent on one moving molecule through the tube structure using electric current, like a tube which will be there, like gas liquid chromatography, which we have learned in the last video lecture, like same way, but here it will be under the influence of electric current. Okay, same setup like that. So the principle here is what capillary electrophoresis, which is this, that is in what is it, an analytical technique, right? So it is based on the electrophoretic mobility. What electrophoretic mobility? With the use of an applied voltage, means we are seeing the mobility with use of what voltage. Okay, so this mobility which is there, it is dependent on what, that is the charge of the molecule, then the viscosity of the molecule and the radius of the atoms. Okay, so coming to the high voltage electrophoresis, here the high voltage electrophoresis, it offers rapid and reproducible method for separation and identification of small amphoteric molecule. So all the amphoteric molecules which are there, they are identified they use one high voltage electrophoresis. So higher voltage which will be there, it will provide a faster whenever high voltage will be there, whatever sample which is there, if we take the example of DNA, it will travel faster through the gel. So however, that voltage which is there, if it is too high, then there is a problem that it will melt the gel or cause simmering or dissociation of DNA bands. Okay, like DNA bands which will be formed, right? There will be dissociation. So the gel concentration and volume which is there, means the thickness, it affects the electrophoretic separation. And also there is risk of what, electrocutation. Okay, it is a big disadvantage. Electrocutation means what, anything which dies, means any cell which is there, if it dies due to electricity, okay, due to electric current, then it is known as electrocutation. Then low voltage electrophoresis. So here what happens, here we are using low voltage. Okay, so low voltage means the source which provides the electricity, we are adjusting it to a low voltage. Okay, so it is used for separation of what, amino acid, peptides, proteins, nucleotides, nucleic acid, charged carbohydrate. Okay, so here the equipment which is there, it will be a horizontal electrophoresis equipment, horizontal, okay, and this horizontal electrophoresis. So the application of this is that in examination of biological and clinical specimen for amino acid and protein, it used for the separation of protein and other high molecular weight substances. So next, moving on to the immunoelectrophoresis. So here what happens, it is also a separation technique, right? It's a separate and identifies the protein based on different electrical charge and reactivity with antibody. So it is completely based on what, the identification of protein based on what, differences in what, electrical charge and reactivity with what, antibodies. So separating medium is usually a agarose gel. Okay, so the gel has alternating walls and slot cut into it. Okay, So the principle here is very simple, that when an electric current is applied, okay, to a slide layer with gel, the antigen mixture placed in the wells, okay, is separated into individual antigen compound according to their charge size. Okay, so if we consider this, according to the charge size, they get separated. Then the step here is like, first we need to pour the electrophoretic gel in that, prepare the sample, then load the gel, then run the gel, means we are exposing it to an electric field, and then staining the gel. Okay, so the application is it is used in toxinomic studies, okay, like of DNA profiling to distinguish different type of species, also the proteins RNA and DNA, also for analysis of drug of abuse, okay, all the type of drugs, then also explosive compounds and the residues of this fire and arson cases. Okay, so that's all for today. If you like this video lecture, do like, share and subscribe. Thank you.